Hello everyone and welcome to a special episode of the UFO Planet Sightings and News Report. My name is Darren Crapo, I'm your host, and on today's program we have some amazing sightings from around the world. We're going to get all that started right after this. Welcome back and thank you everyone for tuning in today. Before I begin today's program, I just want to wish a very happy Thanksgiving Day to the viewers in the United States of America. It's Big Turkey Day down there today, and I hope you all had a fantastic time with your family, friends, and loved ones. I got a lot of messages this morning wishing me a happy Thanksgiving Day. But I'm up here in Canada and we actually celebrate our Thanksgiving Day in October, so we already had our Turkey Day, but we hope that yours went fantastic down there. Now today's program is a little bit of an abbreviated program. Those of you who follow me on my personal Facebook page are already aware that I have some things going on in my family. My father is very, very ill with heart problems. And most of the family has gathered back at our childhood home here in Rosemary, Alberta, so that we can spend as much time with our father as we possibly can. I've had a lot of great times with him over the last couple of weeks, and I intend on having a whole lot more yet. So in order to test the studio out today, I thought I would do a short abbreviated program and just make sure everything works okay and that I can do the program from this location. So let's get started, and we're gonna skip right up to five in a row, but today we're only gonna have three in a row. And yeah, I can count, but as I mentioned before, this is just a test to make sure that the studio works okay. We're gonna head first to Signal Hill, California in the United States of America for case number 52553. If you happen to speak a foreign language such as Spanish, it's gonna make sense.
Veníamos en el freeway. ¿Y cuánta gente se paró?
¿Ah, sí? ¿Qué pasó? ¿En dónde? ¿En dónde?
Aquí en el 134
y el 5. No, aquí en el... Ajá.
¿Vivimos en Venecia de Toño?
Sí, empezó una tormenta, pero bien oscura. Ajá. Y una
No, por eso, pero digo, como viene con la historia...
¿Hace cuántos años nosotros que veníamos en el freeway? ¿Y cuánta gente se paró?
¿Ah, sí? ¿Qué pasó? ¿En dónde? ¿En dónde?
Aquí en el 134 y el 5.
No, aquí en el... Ajá.
¿Vivimos en Venecia de Toño?
Sí, empezó una tormenta, pero bien oscura.
Well, now we're going to head to Helena, Montana. This is from November 4th. Helena, Montana is the capital city of the state of Montana. You drive right by it on Interstate 15 on your way to Salt Lake City, Utah. There was something spotted up in the sky, a couple of objects as a matter of fact, and it was taken from an aircraft. So here we have what looks to be outside of an aircraft window. Not much to look at there, but take a look at those objects in the next photo here. This was taken on the 4th of November, right around the noonish time. So take a look at this object. You can see it enhanced on the left-hand side. Looks pretty amazing there, doesn't it? At least I think it does. And it certainly has that saucer shape that we all love to associate with UFOs, but flying right up above it is an orb. Take a look at that. You can see the arrow pointing to it. So we actually, in this photo, have two shots. Amazing. Next, we're gonna go to Huntington, Indiana for a November 14th sighting. We always show you on the planet where the sightings happen. It makes it a little easier to comprehend where the sightings are. Although this one was shot in Indiana, it's of the moon. Take a look at this. We have an object that's passing in front of the moon and was captured on video using a telescope. Check it out. It's very interesting to look at here. We're going to go into slow motion mode so that we can have a little bit better look at it. You can see the comm trail or whatever it is, some sort of a vapor trail behind the object. But now we're going to take and we're going to replay that again. But this time when the object appears, we're going to slow it down and stop it so that we can have a look and see what it is that's making this amazing trail across the surface of the moon. There we go. So what do we have here? Do we have some sort of an object that's just simply in the atmosphere of the Earth and is making a calm trail behind it and just happened to be captured in this video of the moon? Or is this something that's in outer space in between the Earth and the moon, or something that is much closer to the moon? A lot of options there, aren't there? So it's kind of up to us and up to each individual viewer to check it out. So that's our three in a row that we're going to bill as five in a row today. But that happens sometimes, and actually this is the fourth time that I've recorded this little snippet here today. So it's a good thing I did do some testing out, and I think you'll probably understand that. I mean, I didn't even come prepared. I have on my blue jeans and my running shoes because I left the rest of my suit hanging in the closet back in my home city. But I'm heading home tomorrow just long enough to pick that up and bring it back. But in the meantime, we're going to take a little bit of a break here, and we're going to come back with today's hot clip of the day. Welcome back to the program, and thank you so much for tuning in. Every week I have what I call the hot video clip, and that's the clip that I like the most, or a clip that is going to teach you something. Today's one of the ones that I like the most, and it's coming to us from Jeremy Thomas down in Redland, Florida. Jeremy's a regular contributor to the program, and I think he's a brave soul. He takes a lot of flack sometimes that people don't think what he's captioning has anything to do with UFOs. They think it's a balloon. But we're seeing this orb here now, and you just saw an airplane that passed in front of that orb, so it's going to give you some perspective. But take a look at how fast this object is moving across the sky that Jeremy captured. I think this is amazing. Well done, Jeremy. And that was on the 20th of November. Jeremy always throws in a little bit of a clip here to show us what he's using for equipment, including his Celestron 1000 millimeter telescope and a 160 millimeter video camera. And this is what he captured, you guys. This is kind of amazing. Now, as I mentioned before, Jeremy's a brave man. He takes a lot of flack from a lot of people that say all he captures are balloons. Now, I really don't believe that. I think that Jeremy captures some things that are much too complex to be your average everyday balloon, and this would be one of those times. Take a look at this object we're looking at close up here. Has some sort of a design on, almost looks like the back of a turtle or something like that, doesn't it? And it tends to me, it kind of looks like it's spinning, rotating as well as, you know, flying up there. Now, there is something hanging down from that, and all the balloon people are going to say that's the string for the balloon. And I don't blame you. You know, it's interesting to see. But I'm kind of the guy that says, you know, if you're going to disprove someone, something, or someone, you kind of have to have as much proof to disprove as you do to prove, which makes it difficult. And that keeps us all guessing. It keeps us talking too. This is going to be a great discussion piece that Jeremy has submitted here because it is something fascinating and something that, in my opinion, isn't easily explained away. Now, I know there are those who are going to say this is just a balloon, but like I say, I would really love to hear a little bit more detail as to why you think that. I base pretty much my entire program on having people decide what they're looking at. Now, if it's something that's way out there and that, I'm definitely going to tell you, hey, this isn't real or this is faked or you know, whatever. But this is one instance where I really am looking for the input of my viewers. Something absolutely amazing. 280 times optical zoom magnification going at half speed. So this is really shooting out there a long way. And Jeremy captures a lot of things above Redland, Florida that are exactly like this type of anomaly. And that there's something that we are unable to explain away. So what do you guys think this one is? I think you did an excellent job, Jeremy, and you truly deserved the hot video clip of the day. Absolutely amazing. If it is a balloon, it's an amazing balloon, and I'd like to know what the balloon is of and who makes these balloons if they are balloons. Now, personally, I don't think this one is, but that's just Darren Crapo's opinion. I've been wrong in the past, and I'll certainly be wrong in the future. But that'll give you an idea of what Jeremy's seeing down there in Redland, Florida. And like I say, I'd really be interested to see what you have to say on that one, because it's just weird to look at and amazing at all at the same time, isn't it? I'd just like to say thank you to everyone who's been sending in messages over the past few days. As I mentioned at the beginning of the show, I have moved, temporarily relocated to my family home that I grew up in, and have set up a studio here in my father's home so that I can spend a whole lot more time with him. I just wanted to do a quick show today to test out the studio to make sure it's all fully functional. And then on the next episode, I will return to full length episodes. Again, I want to just say happy Thanksgiving to all my American relatives and friends and all my viewers down in that beautiful country. I hope that you have a great turkey day, and please, someone have lots of turkey and smother in it and gravy just for me. I wish I was there to eat it. My name's Darren Crapo, and this is the UFO Planet Sightings and News Report. I will see you again next week. Thank you so much for your support. Take care.